Here we have some operations involving radicals. You have 5 square roots of 2 times the quantity 4 square roots of 3 minus the square root of 6. And just like with polynomials, we'll use the distributive property, that is, multiply 5 square roots of 2 times each of 4 square roots of 3 and negative square root of 6. Also, like expressions with variables, when you're multiplying this, you can think of the 5 and the 4 like the coefficients. So like if square root of 2 and square root of 3 were some variables, you would just multiply 5 times 4 first. So I'll write that out just to drive that principle home. And then you have the square root of 2 times the square root of 3. And we'll come back to simplifying that. We also have a positive times a negative, so that's going to be a negative right away. And we have 5 times the square root of 2 times the square root of 6. Now 5 times 4 is 20, and because these are both square roots, you can multiply the radicands. The radicand in this case is 2, and in this radical, the radicand is 3. You can multiply what's underneath the radical sign. So it doesn't work with addition, but multiplication it does. So that's going to be times the square root of 6, 2 times 3. Now we have minus 5 times the square root of 2 times 6, which is 12. So we've done the multiplication. Now we have to look to see if we can simplify these radicals. That is, are there any perfect squares in the radicand that we can factor out? And that's just a way to simplify a radical. For the 6, there is no other perfect square that you can factor out. But with the 12, there's a 4 that you can factor out of the 12. So let's rewrite that as 20 times the square root of 6 minus 5 times that perfect square of 4. It's going to stay under a radical for now. So we write square root of 4 times the square root of 3. That's just a way to write square root of 12 there. Let's put it in parentheses so you can see what's happening. Okay. And now you simplify a square root of 4, you know that's just 2. So let's write 20 square root of 6 minus 5 times 2 times the square root of 3. We've just taken this square root of 4 and rewritten it as 2. And then let's just continue to simplify here. You have 20 square root of 6 minus 10 square roots of 3. Now remember I said you can multiply underneath the radical. You can't add or subtract under the radical. We'll see in the next example where we have a special case, but here we can't say 6 minus 3 here. So this is the final answer for this problem. Okay, question B here. 7 square roots of 20 plus 8 square roots of 5. We can't add 20 and 5 here, but we can simplify, that is, factor out a perfect square out of this 20. So let's do that. 7 times the square root of 4 times the square root of 5 plus 8 square roots of 5. So we can then simplify this square root of 4 as 2, or evaluate that square root as 2. So 7 times 2 times the square root of 5 plus 8 square roots of 5. Now you have 14 square roots of 5 plus 8 square roots of 5. And notice how I'm saying that. You have 14 of these square roots of 5 and 8 of these things. Now, when the radicand is the same, you don't add what's underneath the radical sign, but you add these, you can think of them as coefficients. So 14 plus 8 then gives you 22. So 14 of these things plus 8 of these things gives you 22 of these square roots of 5. So this would be your final simplified version of the initial problem.